Hello friends, we are discussing our module 2, that is ecology. So today the topic of discussion is very interesting. I hope you people will definitely enjoy this topic. This topic is too important and very much easy topic. So my topic of discussion is top-down effect and bottom-up effect. Okay, we are going to discuss what exactly is top-down effect first. Okay, so top-down effect. Top-down factors are pressure applied by a higher trophic level to control the population dynamics of the ecosystem. The top predator either suppresses the abundance of its prey or alters its behavior to limit its rate of population growth. Top-down control results in an oscillating trophic cascade, that is, the suppression at one level increases number at the next level. Okay, so in this diagram you can easily understand what basically the concept of top-down control is. So, top predator control population dynamics via an oscillating cascade effect. Okay. So, these are the green plants. As you all know, these are the primary, they are called producers or they are called autotrophs. Okay. This is the first trophic level. Means, as the number of plant increases, okay, there will be less snails, number of frog will increases, and there will be no frogs, no foxes. Okay, this shows top-down effect. Okay, I hope through this diagram you can easily understand what basically the concept is. Yes, that is, suppose we are taking a box. Okay, I am going to divide this box into, or you can say this is a pyramid. Okay. So, suppose I have taken red color. This is plus. And this is also plus. Okay. And this green is minus. This is minus. So, suppose this, in this I am talking about that is the top up effect. Top. Top up effect. What exactly the thing which is going here? I am going to discuss. Suppose we are talking about pond ecosystem. Okay. So at first trophic level, phytoplanktons are there. And in second trophic level, zooplanktons are there. Then small fishes and then large fishes. These are the top consumers, you can say. So, suppose if I am talking about top-up effect, suppose the number of phytoplanktons are increasing. Okay, suppose the number of phytoplanktons, they are increasing, or we are providing the phytoplankton, that plus indicate means here the population of phytoplankton basically increases. So, as the phytoplankton number increases, zooplankton automatically decreases. That is the Y sign indicates. And if the zooplankton decreases, then small fishes will increase. Definitely it will increase. And small fishes will increase, then large fishes will decrease. This shows the top-up effect. Means, suppose here we can take vice versa also. That is, suppose we are using pink color. This is suppose minus. Here I am using blue. That is plus, again plus, and here it will be minus. Suppose at this is the first trophic level. Okay, so phytoplanktons in this trophic level, these are negatively controlled or they are lesser in number, you can say. Here phytoplanktons are lesser in number, and what about zooplankton? It will definitely increase in this case. Then small fishes, it will decrease, and large fishes, it will increase. Okay, so this is all about top-up effect. Okay, now we can easily understand what exactly the bottom-up effect. Okay, first I am going to discuss the basics of bottom-up effect. Okay, so yes, bottom-up effect. Here Nutrient supply control population dynamics via effect on producer productivity. Means, if there will be no fertilizer, there will be less snails, there will be less frogs, and there will be less foxes. Means, bottom-up effect are pressure that limit the availability of resource to lower trophic level. That is the producers. Lack of resource at lower trophic levels suppress the abundance of organism at higher trophic levels. Okay, population growth will be reduced for higher level as the suppression of bottom restrict energy supply to the top. Human activity can often limit resource availability and hence inadvertently exert bottom-up pressure in an ecosystem. Okay, so this is the bottom-up effect. With the help of diagram, again I am going to explain. Okay, so if I am talking about this bottom up effect, okay, this is the column I am taking, and again I will divide these columns into the different trophic levels. Okay, suppose here this is the first trophic level, second trophic level, third trophic level, fourth trophic level. Means we are starting from bottom. That is why the name is called bottom up effect. Okay. If phytoplanktons are increasing, then zooplankton also increases, then small fishes also increases, and in large fishes will definitely increases. Suppose we have taken from minus, that is the minus, 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 and again minus. Again from the bottom, bottom up effect as the name suggests. So from the trophic level first, phytoplankton, zooplankton, small fishes, large fishes. If phytoplanktons are less, zooplankton will automatically less, and small fishes will automatically less, and then also large fishes. So it is all about bottom up effect. Okay. With the help of this block diagram, you can easily understand what exactly the thing is. Bottom up effect. Okay. So in this diagram, you can also easily understand. Here one point I skipped, that is the top down control. Means keystone species, that was my previous video. Keystone species, I have given separate video on this topic. Commonly exert top-down control by preventing lower trophic level from monopolizing essential resources. Okay, I hope you all have understood this video very well. So friends, if you want some more detailed discussion and some problem solving session on top-down and bottom-up control, and the question which I have asked in so many entrance examinations related to biotechnology, life sciences. Okay. So, you can register yourself for online classes. That will be very much fruitful for you all. In that series, I will discuss separately all the problem solving session. Means all the topics which I have already discussed, I will give all the problem solving session. The question which I've asked earlier and the question which can be asked in competitive exams. So, you can register yourself for that particular online classes. For more details, please call or WhatsApp on my contact number as it was given on my slide. That is 0969618-7810. For more details, you can call or WhatsApp me on this number. Share this video, like this video and like my channel. And please subscribe to my channel, share this video with your friends, colleagues, teachers, and batchmates. Thank you, friends. I hope we will meet soon. Thank you once again.